Thank you for viewing Craftwood Cabinets video for refacing the kitchen. This is the existing kitchen that will be removing all the doors, refacing the cabinets, replacing a couple cabinets. Counters will be removed with new granite tops. We'll be replacing all the drawers and adding some pull-out shelves. These two cabinets will be removed in the corner and we'll be replacing it with two new cabinets. For better corner accessibility. We'll be adding a sleeve to the back of the island with some wainscoting. Notice there's no crown molding at the top of the wall cabinets. So there's really not much room with the doors going tight to the ceiling. It's the front of the island. Taking these shelves out, adding pull-out shelves. Pull-out shelves helps the cabinet look a little more new on the inside. Having the pull-out shelves in there, you don't really notice the interior as much. See how I have a void area way in the back, really hard to get to. These would be the drawers that are being replaced. Hardware is practically falling apart. It's not a very good system to start with. We'll be replacing these with full extension side mount ball bearing drawer slides. We're starting to remove the counters, the drawer slides, the doors. Once all the doors and drawers and tabs are taken off, we'll start to sand the face of the face frames with an 80 grit sandpaper. This will give you a better view of the inside of the cabinet for that storage in the corner area. This area is going to be removed and replaced with new cabinetry. Now I have the corner cabinets removed, ready for the new cabinets. Removing some of the wall cabinet doors. Now the new corner cabinet's installed. Notice we've added a filler to the bottom of the wall cabinets. This is so that we can help cover the light that gets added to the bottom of the wall cabinets for under cabinet lighting. This is the sandpaper that we're using, 80 grit. We'll be sanding the face of the frames. This will help the glue stick a little better when we glue the veneer on the face. Now we need to prep the side of the cabinets for the finished side sheeting. We'll need a filler. These fillers will be made so that they're flush to the side of the face frame. It'll be attached to the side of the cabinet with some construction adhesive heavy duty. It's a really good glue. Once these fillers are attached to the back side of the cabinet near the wall, then we can apply our 1/4-inch plywood over top of these and over top of the side of the face frame. 1/4-inch plywood will be flush to the front of the face frame. And then once this happens, we'll be covering the front edge of the plywood with a really small paper type veneer. This is a 1/4-inch plywood. It's pre-finished in the shop. Notice you'll still see the edge of the plywood on the front of the cabinet, but that's going to be covered up with a 10 mil backer veneer, and you won't see any plywood edging once that's put over the face of the cabinet. We always use 1/4-inch plywood on the sides of the cabinets, and then a veneer, which is a 10 mil veneer, on the face of the frame. Once we add this glue, put the panel on, we use a micro pin nailer. Just use very small pin nails. The head head size is about the size of a needle, which is great for filling. They're really hard to see, and this will hold the panel in place until the glue dries. Now this is our crown molding that we'll be using. Notice how close it comes to the opening of the door, not leaving much room for the door. So what we're going to do is we're going to add this filler piece into the opening, and then we'll veneer over it. And this will give us a little distance between the bottom of the crown and the bottom opening of the cabinet. So we need to add all these filler pieces to all the wall cabinets in this area. You can see we have this side completed with the filler pieces ready for veneer. Now we're starting to apply our vertical strips of veneer on the cabinet. Nice thing about running these strips on the cabinets, where the two cabinets come together, we can put the veneer over the seam. So once you're refaced, you don't see any seams where the cabinets come together. So sometimes you can actually have your kitchen look better than new by just refacing it. Very important to make sure you press the veneer down with a roller or some sort of a press block once the veneer is attached. This ensures a long-lasting bond for the glue to the cabinet. If you didn't do this, there's a good chance it could fail in a couple years. Now we're going to start cutting our cross member pieces. This veneer is pre-coated in the shop. We use a slitter to slit up the widths that we want, and then the paper cutter to do the final cross cut to make the part fit. Now we're taping off the veneer at all the areas where the cross members come in so that we don't get any glue on the face of the veneer as we're gluing. This is our respirator that we wear when we're spraying the glue. And this is our glue gun. We use compressed air to spray the glue onto the face of the frame. This is a spray board that we use so we don't get overspray inside the cabinet or on the veneer by holding it up into the opening, spraying onto the wood where we want to attach the veneer. This shows us spraying the top rail on the cabinet. We also spray the back of the veneer. Then once the glue dries on the cabinet and the veneer, then we apply it to the cabinet. So now we have most of the wall cabinet veneer done. Now this is the island cabinet we made a sleeve for. The sleeve had some wainscot panels on the sides and in the back, and the sleeve flushes off at the front of the cabinet. What we're going to need to do is veneer over the edge of the sleeve in the face of the far right, far left style, so it looks like one cabinet. This is a wainscot panel on the side there. Now we need to veneer this front edge in the face of the rest of the island. All the drawer slides are attached, the full extension ball bearing slides for the pull-out shelves and the drawers. We'll be adding a 5-inch base molding to the bottom of the cabinet to make it look more like furniture. This is what the base molding added. The veneer is on the front of the cabinet. Drawer slides are in place, ready for the drawers and pull-outs. We'll be touching up this edge with a stain. This is where the veneer had to go over the edge of the sleeve, and we had to file it in. And then we use a light sandpaper and a little bit of stain and some top coat. Now we can see that the granite tops are in. We got our shelf in the corner cabinet. Very nice corner open section. We make these cabinets a little different than the standard. We make one side at 42 and the other side at 36, and it gives you a lot larger opening to get into that huge space in the back corner. The crown molding's on. Basically ready for our doors. This is the bottom of the sink base lies. Sink bases get damaged over the years. And this is a particle board, basically raw particle board. We use a plastic melamine called a mica board on the inside of our new cabinets. It's a laminated board that we purchased laminated, and it's great for moisture barrier. These are our doors that we'll be applying to the fronts of the cabinets. So now we have all the doors on, the handles in place. And this is what it looks like completed. You see in the corner that one door is larger than the other door. And this opens up to 180 degrees. Easy access into that corner area. Very open. And the cabinet to the left of that is new as well. This totally changed the whole storage area, that corner that they used to have. These are the type of hinges that we're using, just to wrap around. We don't finish the inside edge of the cabinet. This is our 1/8-inch rubber bumper for the doors. These are the drawers. These are a melamine drawer. It's a plastic laminated board that we use to build the drawers with. Everything's 5/8, the bottoms, the sides, the front, and the back. Very strong drawer. This is a pull-out splice unit. We still need to get the hardware for it. There'll be two racks mounted to it. So when you pull it out, you'll have dividers for the trays.